Hey everyone, it's Bass Junkie transmitting from Hamburg, Germany, back with a new video. And first up, before I go into the video topic and stuff, I've caught a flu, so I've got the sniffles, and if my voice sounds a little weird today, well, this happens, and when I worked at the record store, I had like sneezing attacks and stuff, so this might happen as well, so be prepared. I'm not that like on top healthy as I used to be, so just a short one because I got mail yesterday, and what I got is, well, an envelope which comes from Berlin from a guy called, I hope I don't butcher the name here, Kai Fagaszynski, which I haven't heard of yet, and I haven't looked him up on, like, I don't know, Discogs or somewhere, but it feels like there is stuff in here, and there's might be a CD in here as usual in these packages, and I don't know anything about that guy, so I'm curious what might be in there. So opening stuff, and there is, well, this is like a very tight envelope. These come in like various sizes, and this is like the very small size, obviously, so this CD is sitting tight, but anyway, we got it. We got a Oh, I see things. And what we got here is a name that is definitely familiar, which is the International Nothing, with a nice turtle and squid picture on the promo sheet. But I don't have any clue where I have heard the name. I'm pretty sure I reviewed some of their albums, or one album, maybe back in the past, which might mean like a few years ago. So, well, the International Nothing is a name that clicks with me, and I totally like the turtle, squid, jellyfish. And let's see what is on there. The release date is on February 18th, which will be soon. SCD, LP and Bandcamp download, collectively composed by Kai Fagaszynski and Michael Tieke, which is a duo that is the International Nothing. And they define themselves as Berlin-based psychoacoustic clarinet duo, which was formed in 2000, which means they reach like adulthood right now, like together as a band. So congrats to that. Collectively composed multi-layered sound sculptures using multiphonics, beat frequencies, and different tones as an integral part of their language, musical language, I guess. And, there is a discography on here, and there is a album which is called The Power of Negative Thinking on Monotype, which was The International Nothing and Something, which, as far as I remember, so I might be kind of like off a little bit, but was the International Nothing with a few guest musicians, which are like subsumized. Is this correct? English speakers, if not, please correct me in the comments down there. Subsumized, I guess, under the and nothing thing. And yeah, I remember that album, and it actually is sitting somewhere around here or there or there or there, because there are like piles of CDs and stuff. And there is an album, and I will get this out of these shiny glued things. What is it, a wrapper? I don't know. And it sits tight in here as well, so I will like just remove it because these very thin protective foils are nice, but somehow the glue on that seems to unglue and get stuck everywhere else, so I don't want this. But here is the cover, very nice, like a unusual format, the International Nothing, In Doubt We Trust. Here's the gatefold, which is more like submarine life, and on the back also Submarine Life. The label is Ftari and the International Nothing. So Ftari is spelled F-T-A-R-R-I. There's a website on there, ftari.com, and here we got the CD, which comes, this is handy, in a also protective sheet, so it doesn't get damaged by the cover. There we go, International Nothing. In Doubt We Trust. So, interesting title. And I totally like the format, because if you compare it to a usual CD, it's a little higher, but a little, as you can see maybe here, a normal CD is a little bit longer, but can you see here as a comparison? So it's an unusual format, which I totally like. It's more like a book. It feels like a book, and the cover is like very, I don't know, cardboard, but very thick, heavy cardboard. So I am very thankful. So shout out to Mr. Fragaschinski for sending this, and you will read a review on that on my website lifestyles.de soon. So have a look down there in the description box, because you can find the link to that website down there, and also to my other social media sites and stuff. And also, if you want to support, as usual, there is a Discogs link down there, so you can buy stuff from Discogs, and this will go, the money I will get from there will go into my channel, kind of, or into things related or whatever. So this will be a nice way to support me and to get some new music or some old music you don't have or you don't know. Just have a look down there and like check the seller link I've got down there, because Amazon sponsored links and stuff are not for me. And well, YouTube is weird. There's still no update about whether the demonetization will happen. I guess it will, but there are also their politics right now, although it's the last 10 days in which the monetization will work, is kind of strange, because my last video, the Toxic Industries thing, I've been talking about the t-shirt and print quality and stuff. It was demonetized while uploaded, so at 95% it was the monetization button went yellow and is like possibly not eligible for monetization or not suitable for all advertisers or something like that. Then I asked them to review that, because you can like click a button and then it's like, okay, you have to tell them, well, my video is suitable for all advertisers and stuff. And then usually they only review videos that have like 1,000 views in a day, but somehow it works. Then monetization was active. Then it was deactivated for a few hours, and I requested another review, and then it was reactivated again. So I guess they're shifting quite a lot in terms of politics and monetization and stuff. So YouTube is a weird place. I haven't been following through on what is happening with the whole thing, but anyway, I don't care, because I don't care, I guess. And I will continue to make videos on a regular, maybe not on a regular, but we'll see. And as you know, if you have any requests and stuff down there, comment section, I will get back to you as soon as possible. And now I'm out into editing, and will be like quick in terms of uploading. This might be online in 4 hours, maybe. We'll see. So I'm going to talk to you later, and the next one is coming soon.